Yeah, baby boy, in the place to be. I'm writing shit that I feel. Raps of black steel in the hour of commotion, emotion of calm. It's like that of an ocean devotion, cause I'm the earth, wind, and fire. A hip hop by Rakim and Short, I've been inspired. My shit knocks and fire. Mints are cats with 17s. 10, time is money. The mind is funny. How it's spent on getting it up.
The reasons. The reasons that we're here. The reasons that we feel our feelings won't disappear. The reasons why I feel our feelings won't disappear is because in my life you always seem to reappear. You look so good you can be my wife. Every time I stop and stare into your beautiful eyes, I get trapped. Not between your thighs, but between your mind. You have me feeling like a drunk elect because you're the best of me and I'm the best of you. So the reasons that we're here. The reasons that we feel our feelings won't disappear is because all we ever did was love each other and fight maybe once or twice. And when we fought, it was epic. Canoe would make our relationship so epileptic. From you, I felt the love. Everyone wondered why I did so much unusual things, but it was because you're my angel sent from heaven above. You made me feel like a dove that could fly free. That's why the reasons. The reasons that I'm here, the reasons that I feel my feelings won't disappear, is because I never stopped loving you, regardless if you ever stopped loving me. I've always been there to block you from your pain and shield you from the rain that fell from the sky. I remember I felt like I wanted to die when we broke up, December 31st, that was the worst. 120 seconds before New Year's Eve. Tick tock. Tick tock. As the seconds dropped, it became a punishing reality. And it stopped being my queen. When you stopped coming around, I missed your luscious lips that made such beautiful sounds. But it's okay because I'm still here today because the reasons that we're here, the reasons that we feel our feelings won't disappear. It's simply because of love. I'll always love you, and don't forget I'll always be a king. I was the first to treat you like a queen. You'll never have to worry about anything when you're around me. But if you do, just play your song and I'll come running. The reasons that we're here, the reasons that we feel our feelings won't disappear. Thank you.
Okay, y'all, so this one's called Do You Ever? And it's actually not written. Everything right now is off of your brain and off of my heart. So, yeah. It's called Do You Ever? Do you ever take the time to realize how much beauty that I see in you? Do you ever think to yourself that maybe when we separated I was a little down? Did you ever take the time to realize that maybe one day I was ready to get on one knee, RJ? Did you ever think of the day that I would think of walking down the runway to see you model the bride's dress? To take my last name? To share everything with no shame. Did you ever? Did you ever take the time to realize that when we separated on December 31st, I cried every day? Did you ever? Seem to look at me in my eyes and realize that I was the man for you. Did you ever? Did you ever think that I could make you smile better than anybody else or take anybody else away from you? Did you ever think that I would be the man to be able to take you on a beautiful dance or a romantic night? Did you ever? Did you ever think that maybe you could change somebody from the hood? Or did you ever think that maybe I was able to take their last name because I loved you so much? Did you ever think that my words could be speaking more volumes than any ring that I could ever buy you because your heart beat goes with mine? While we sleep, we breathe together. You breathe in and I breathe out because we need each other. I take in the oxygen from you. And it's such love that I have for you. So sometimes I ask, did you ever think of me? Did you think of me on those sleepless nights when you were by yourself, never being held tight? Did you think of me when I did hold you tight and treat you right? Did you ever think the day that I would bring out a wedding ring? Did you ever love me? This poem is for anybody that ever had a question to see if anybody ever loved someone. As you can see, I have a woman here that I lost off of my own stupidity, but off of my own smartness, or good looks, whichever one you're better. I got her back. So at this time, on this special occasion, I wanted to write Do You Ever for Sophia Brunelli. And I love you. The words you say sound so sweet. From the first time we met, you lived in my sleep. I tend to fantasize about your beauty blessing my life, even though you're already my potential wife. It's so sweet. The way that you treat me, I know that I'm winning because every time you're in my arms, I feel like singing a beautiful song. Our hearts intertwining like a beautiful poem that has rhyme and rhythm, rhythm and rhyme. The first time I had you, everyone began to hate. But it didn't matter because I still wanted to take you on romantic dates. When I touch you, my hormones go out of control. I feel like I live deep within your soul as if it's my own home. The smell of your body is so sweet. From day one, I wanted to sweep you off your feet. Waking up, I realized that was just my fantasy. We've never talked about you being my wife or even being the love of my life. I imagine that when I do have you, people will begin to hate. And I promise I will still take you on those romantic dates. But until that day arrives, I will continue to sleep so you can continue to linger in my dreams. Because those dreams pump blood into my fantasies that make my life, oh, so sweet.
Running back to class and learn some historical quotes. Learning about Rosa Parks and Jesse Jackson. Understanding that a fist can be used as a peaceful action. But at the same time, going back to street history, you learn about the real Rick Ross. And not the fake one claiming to be a boss. See, street history and book history go together if you move with it. Move with it, quick, hurry, pick up a pen. So you can learn where Martin Luther King ended, so you can understand where you will begin. So I ask you again, where did you get your education?
The school or the streets?
Peace.